Hi, this is A Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about SDK-less ad mediation networks. Okay, so as many of you may know, I make a lot of my money through ad networks like AdMob. AdMob is the one I use the most, but I've used other networks too, and we kind of use, you know, we use AppLovin, Facebook Audience Network, and a few others. But AdMob pays the most for us. Now, I know I've spoken to other app developers who don't get a very good result with AdMob, and they get better results with other networks. And then I tried those other networks, and they don't work as well for me. So it is kind of a thing. I think it depends on your app, you know, where your biggest user base is and all that kind of stuff. So it pays to try different things. But the nice thing about AdMob and a few other networks is that they have something called ad mediation. So what that means is that you just include the AdMob SDK within your app and just say show ad, show ad, show ad. And what that will do is it will check all the other networks that you have set up, and it'll see if those networks pay more than AdMob. And if they do, they'll show the ad from that network. Otherwise, they'll just show the AdMob one. So that way you try to get the most revenue as possible. Now, I spoke about this already in a video, but this week I want to talk about something I learned about just a couple months ago. I was on this webinar from AdMob, and they were talking about the SDK-less mediation networks. And I didn't even know this was possible, because when we first set it up for mediation, we just added everything into AdMob, and then none of the ads were served. And the reason was that you actually have to include the SDK from that network within the app. So like if I want to include, say, Facebook Audience Network within my AdMob ads, I would have to repackage my app and put that SDK within there. And which is, it's fine if you have a native app, but if you're using something like a framework like Unity, Corona SDK, Ionic, some of the ones that we use a lot, that it's not easy to find plugins for all that kind of stuff, you know. So we kind of just stick with AdMob. So anyway, back to SDK-less networks. So some networks will let you actually include those ads through AdMob through mediation, and there's no dependency on adding the SDK. So what that means is that you could just set it up. You don't even have to redeploy your app. You can just set it up, see how it does, and it will check these networks and then display it. So right now there's not that many that allow this, but there's a few. So you see here, you can see there's Arki, Drawbridge, M.M, and Smato. Now, I know there's a few more besides this now, but I've been trying Smato for the past few weeks. I'm going to show you how that went for me. So it's easy to do. If you have a look at my screen here, there's you just go through and follow the instructions on how to actually set this up. And then, like I said, you don't have to download the SDK. You just set it up within there. And then you go to your AdMob page and go to the monetize tab, and then if you click on, say, you know, your ad units, and you say check the ad sources and say plus ad network, then you have all the different ad networks that you can add through monetize through mediation. We talked about this a few weeks ago, but you can see some of them here are SDK-less, so you know, you could just go ahead and add this and just basically set up an account with Drawbridge, add everything in there, and then just wait for the ads to start showing up, and then check the Drawbridge account to see how it does. So it's a lot easier to just try these things out for a few days and see whether or not they pay very well for you, whether or not it's even worth your time, and that kind of stuff. So we've done this with Smato, and let me just show you how this is doing for us. I put this on two of my apps just to try it out. I tried to put it on EarSpy, you know, the big one, and I put it on Korean Flash Quiz, which is doing really well at the moment. So you can see here, it's not really that impressive in terms of, and it's nothing to do with the platform. It has to do with this network. But you see here, the revenue here was like $1.81 over the last week, which is not really very good. Now you might think that's better than nothing, but it isn't. I mean, if that's all you're going to get paid, it's not even worth troubling your users with ads. You might as well just not show ads at all. In addition to everything else, so I'm going to keep trying to, you know, I've spoken with somebody at Smato as to how we could get that up. I mean, the eCPM here is 20 cents, which is really, really low. But what I like about this is Korean Flash Quiz is a Corona SDK game. So like Corona SDK doesn't have that many ad networks available. I mean, they have a handful, but then you have to like deploy it. You have to bring everything down. If it doesn't work, you have to release another version. With this, we could just go through and start putting that through. So I'm excited about this. At the moment, we don't, like I said, it's not paying a lot, considering how much, if I show you the AdMob revenue for today, well, it's still early in the morning, but it's 10 pounds. Yesterday it was 95 pounds. So, you know, there's a big difference. We're still seeing, there's still a lot of testing to do. I'm going to try out some of these other SDK networks. But if you have any success with them, you know, let me know. It's something that's, I think, is really, really exciting in terms of being able to try out different things. So try it for a few days, see if it works, and then just remove it without having to redeploy your app, without having to change any code, without having to add any new permissions or anything like that. So anyway, that's it for this week. I hope it's been helpful. If you've had any success with the SDKless networks, please let me know because I'm really, really interested. That's it. I'll talk to you next week. Hey, I really hope you liked that video. Now, I do these once a week, so if you want to hear more or you want to hear more about our experiences with the App Store, either Google Play or iTunes, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and please like this video and leave a comment. I love reading the comments. I love hearing what you have to say, even if it's just hello or whatever. And like I say before, if you're not sure what to say in a comment, like I never know what to say in a comment, I'll make it easier for you. Like if you liked it, just go ahead and say gnarly, which is an 80s term. Or if you didn't like it, just say bogus. And if you didn't think any of it, just say eh, right? So that would be a big help. And another thing you could do, which I'd really appreciate it, if you're on the App Store and you want to try one of our apps, look up some of the Overpass apps, applications either on iTunes or Google Play, and leave a review and let us know what you think about it, either good or bad. But we're all trying to build up in the market, so that would be a big help. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week.